talented Warriors captain Matthew Boissonneau leading his team into action against the Brampton Excelsiors, a Whitby win would pull them level with 14 points in the standings. Whitby scoring first, nice setup from Graydon Hogg to Tanner Cook, and he places a shot behind Tyler Smith before the 1-0 lead. Ian McKinnon plays a bit of give and go here with Cook. He gets the ball right back, and in his debut, it gets the goal. It is 2-0, and the bench even happier than McKinnon was about that goal. 3-0 now, and don't blink or you'll miss goal number 4 right off the draw. Boissonneau will collect this ball and score on the left side of Smith. The Warriors jumping out to a decent-sized lead in a hurry. Brampton's first goal comes off the transition. Josh Thompson blocks the Bryce Yetman attempt, finds the loose ball before connecting with Seth Van Scheppen, who deposits past Brett Dobson, and they are now on the board. Half a minute later, Luke Keenan double-teamed, manages to get the ball to Parker Pfeiffer, and just like that, it is a 5-1 Warriors. On the power play now, but it was only a matter of time before Jeff Teat and Clark Patterson get going. Teat with the precision pass, and he will score to make it 5-3. However, still with the man advantage, Dyson Williams to Hogg, and he gets that shot off in a hurry. It is 6-4 after the first period. Second period, Tanner Cook blows past Van Scheppen on the way to his second of 3 goals in a row that would give the Warriors a 3-goal lead again at 8-5. Cook, the setup man this time, over-the-shoulder pass for Dyson Williams, who just unloads past Smith. Whippy given a 5-minute major for high sticking, and Brampton take advantage. Teats and then Austin Hasten scoring within a 34-second span to narrow the gap. Penalties littering this game. We have 3-on-3 action now, and that allows Williams the space to rip his second of the night, making it 11-8, headed to the final period. The high-scoring game, not without its moments of goaltending brilliance. Smith, a double save here, the second one in acrobatic style. Warriors once looked in control until the wave of penalties. Hasten showing patience here and goes high over Dobson, and for the first time since the 34-second mark of the game, we are tied. How's this for a swing? Brampton hits on the post on what would have been a go-ahead goal. Ryan Barnable grabs the rebound, legs it towards goal at the other end, and lets the shot go perhaps before Smith thought he would, and Barnable gets his team on top. 9 seconds later, Boissonneau put it on the board. The Warriors had reason to pack it in after letting it slip away, but fought right back. Not done yet. Brampton can get within a goal with time remaining, but look at the save by Brett Dobson in the stick. That is unbelievable. A second look shows you just how amazing that was. Tanner Cook led the way with 5 goals and 3 assists. Williams, 7 points. And we hear from the new captain about what the C means to him. The will to win and even it getting it done the hard way in a 14-13 victory.
Honestly, it's amazing to lead a group of guys like this, and I'm hoping for a strong year, and we're going to finish it out like we always do and get into playoffs and keep it rolling. So it's honestly the most humbling experience I can get. Once we believed in ourselves and we pushed the ball and our defense and Dauber made some great saves and our penalty kill helped us out a lot, then the momentum just came with us in the end, and we pushed through and we got face-offs and our offense came to life and our D played strong.
Yeah, for sure. Penalties always suck. Just battling back, buying people out, a couple dumb penalties, but just sticking to good defense, good penalty killers. Dauber played a hell of a game. We just found a way to keep the ball in their end and do a pretty good job and keep the ball out of our net. Yeah, for sure. You're not always going to stop a 5-on-3, 5-on-4, but our players did a hell of a job, and we pulled it out with a big win.